Do you find that your audio drifts out of sync like mine is now during long duration recordings? If so, I'm going to show you an easy and efficient way to fix it. Let's get undone.
Drill undone. He's crazy.
What is happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and today we're going to be tackling audio drift using Adobe Audition. Now, there's other programs you can use to deal with this as well, but I'm most comfortable with Audition, and it integrates well into Premiere Pro, so that will help with the efficiency angle that I'm going for as well. Now, there's a few different ways to fix audio drift, but this is the method that I've been using for the last couple months now, and it's really easy, and it's shaved quite a bit of time off my workflow. And the sync drifting that I'm referring to is when you record your audio on a different device than your camera, and then you try to sync them up in post. The problem is that the audio from the one source runs slightly faster than the other, and so when you try and sync them up over a long recording, it can be really noticeable by the end just how out of sync they are. But let's jump into Audition and Premiere, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so here we have a clip. This is just a long video recording that I made, and this is the audio track that came with the recording right out of the camera. It's not great audio, it's just throwaway audio that you use for syncing. And then if we jump over here to Audition, this is where I have the audio that I recorded externally in Audition, straight from a microphone through the interface. This is clean audio, not noisy, not using the camera preamps. This is the audio that we want. But if we export this audio, and we'll save it as vocal track one so that I know what it is. And then if we jump into Premiere here and we try and sync it up, now I'm gonna do this manually just by trying to sync up the claps that I did with the two audio tracks. There's obviously, you know, algorithms that do this, but I always find that they're never quite accurate, especially over a long recording. You generally have to cut the clip up into multiple pieces in order for it to work that effectively. So I'm just gonna sync it up manually here, but syncing it up manually isn't the greatest in Premiere because you have to go based on frames and sometimes the audio doesn't really line up perfectly, but I'm gonna do my best. So I'll just get it as close as I can and then, yeah, that sounds pretty good. So, okay, so now that we have the beginning synced up, we'll jump over to the end and you'll be able to see the drift that I'm talking about. So if we zoom in here, you'll see that there is now considerable difference compared to where the claps were. That's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining. So that's really out of sync. Like, that's not going to work at all. It's not going to line up with the mouth anymore. And so that's no good. Now, the way that you would fix that conventionally, like I said, is you would put lots of little cuts in here, and then you could move each clip and sync them all up individually. And this is what I used to do before, and what I've seen a lot of other videos and tutorials recommend. And it works well, it's just that it can be quite time consuming. So now I don't even bother with any of that. So let's just undo all of that, and I'll even get rid of the track that we brought in from Audition. And so what we're gonna do first is right click on the scratch track from the camera and choose edit clip on Adobe Audition. Now that's gonna take that and open it up in Audition. And now here we'll have that. Now we're gonna click on multi-track in the top left-hand corner, and then that's gonna show our original good audio that we were talking about earlier that we recorded in Audition. And then I'm gonna bring the camera track in here so that we can use it for syncing. And we're gonna sync the beginning the same way that we did in Premiere Pro. So I'm just gonna slide this over and I'm gonna line up the claps. And it's much easier to sync things in Audition than it is in Premiere Pro, again, because of that whole frame restriction. So we can really line it up a lot better than we could. We have much more control over it. All right, so that's pretty good. So now let's jump over to the end of the track. And again, you can see how out of sync these two clips are. But now we have this advantage in Audition that we can grab this little thing up here that shows the stretch tool, and we can actually just drag the clip out. And what this is doing is slowing it down so that it matches the rate of the track from the camera. And we can fine tune that really well and get it nice and synced up that way. So that's it, it's already in sync. And we did this by slowing it down, but you don't have to worry, it's not gonna affect your vocal pitch at all. It's only being slowed down by like 0.001%, so it's not that big of a deal. But rather than just typing in the number, which you can do, I like the stretch tool because you can fine tune it and you can use claps at the end to, like, you know, really get it, just really dial it in without having to guess different numbers. I like the slider, it works really well. Now once you're happy with the sync, you're gonna wanna make sure that the second track, the track from the camera, is muted. And you're gonna go over here and click mute. And the reason why this is important is because we wanna use the entire session, but we don't wanna hear the second track because it's noisy and it's no good and just our scratch track. But we need it there and we need to preserve the positioning of it so that we can keep the spacing the same. You see how there's this chunk of empty space at the end, and at the beginning there's some empty space on our Audition track. That way when we go to multi-track and we go to mix down session to the entire session, we're actually gonna be mixing down both tracks into one, but we're not gonna hear the second track because it's muted, but we're gonna be able to keep the duration exactly the same. This way we don't have to re-sync it in Premiere because we know that it's gonna be the exact length because we're basing it on the body of the clip that we exported from Premiere into Audition. So it's going to be the exact perfect length so that when we go back into Premiere, we don't have to resync it using that finicky frame by frame syncing. That we don't have to do that. But here, I'll show you. Now at this stage, by the way, this is when you could go and you could normalize and add any effects or whatever before we exported it. Get the audio sounding exactly how you want it to sound if you want to do an EQ or whatever. And then export the file. And this time I'm going to type in vocal sync so I know this is the good one. And so we'll go ahead and export that. And now over here in Premiere, we're going to import it into our project. And all we have to do now is just, like I said, drag it right onto the timeline. And as you can see, boom, it immediately lines up with the beginning collapse because, you know, it's not perfect, but I didn't do it perfectly on Audition, but it's pretty close. You just take a little bit more time on Audition when you sync it up and it'll be perfect. And then if we go ahead and check out the end of the track, we'll see that it stayed in sync pretty much for the majority. Again, not perfect because I didn't do a perfect job, but really, really close. Let's have a listen. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video helpful, or at least... So that's very good. If we mute it and we check it out full screen, at least entertaining. And if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing. That's definitely a passable sync. And we can even take our new track and just replace the other one with it and then link them back up. And now we just have one big chunk of video and audio that are linked together and they're in sync. And this is advantageous so we don't have to do multiple things to multiple different cuts and apply to all the different clips. We can just do things that we want to the whole thing. So say if you wanted to add a grade to it, you can just drag that down and drop it on. It just applies everywhere. If you want to do something in the audio or whatever, you just can do the whole clip. And I think that it's much easier and it's a more efficient method. And I did this whole thing in like 3 minutes while doing this video. So if you concentrate on it, you could probably do it even faster. And it produces a much better, cleaner result than the other methods that I've seen. This is the way that I would recommend if you have software that supports these features. Just that stretch tool and then drag it over. And if you export first into Audition, match it up, then export the whole session like that while keeping your bumpers, then you don't have to resync it. You just drop it in and it's good to go. And This is my favorite method. I hope that this is helpful to you. And while we're on the topic of audio, I also want to remind you guys that that giveaway that I was doing with DD Microphone for the excellent VMic D3 Pro is still going on, but only for a few more days. It ends on January 2nd. So if you're watching this video before January 2nd, go check out the links. I'll put one in the description and in the comments that you can enter the giveaway. There's multiple ways to enter, and you'll have two chances to win because we're going to give away two microphones. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, feel free to hit the dislike button twice. All right, I'm done.